G'day and welcome back to Buildsome, and this is the fourth and last video on how to establish the length of your hip. And in this video we're going to look at using a steel square. So obviously we need to have a look at our steel square, and you can see I've got two buttons positioned on the square here, or you could use a fence, but obviously we need to work out where these buttons are going to go. So as in the previous examples, this roof is a 30 degree pitched roof, and if you use tan times the roof pitch, or tan times 30, you will work out that the rise per metre is 0.577. Now obviously 0.577 is not going to fit on a tongue that is only 400 mil long, so we have to make that a little bit smaller. Now I've divided that by 3 in this case, not because that's the only measurement that will fit on here, but it's more determined by the measurement that's going to go on our blade, which I'll explain in a second. So 0.577 divided by 3 gives us 192 millimeters. So I've set this button up to exactly 100. Going from the outside, so it'd be 192 millimeters, which is right there, and I've got the button sitting right on that one. Now on the other side, on the blade, knowing that the length of our hip per meter is actually 1.414, if you divide that by 3 we get 471, and that just fits on the blade of our square. That's why we had to divide this one by 3 as well. Can't divide them by different numbers, has to be the same. So both divided by 3 to get them down to a ratio. However, you'll notice with this button, I have not got it sitting on 471, which would be about there. Right, and the reason for this is, with the shape of these buttons, if I was to draw a line between 192 and 471, it would end up being about there. Okay, so the button will actually hold the square off the timber a little bit. So what you have to do is, the best way to do it is to sit the square on the timber, line it up with the actual number you want, and then push the button along the square until it touches. So the button's not on that measurement, but the square lines up where it crosses the timber. So it's on the right measurement there. So just be aware of that when you set your square up. Different buttons will give you different amounts of error. So just make sure you place your square on the timber on the right dimensions, then make your buttons fit. So having that done, I now have the right bevel, plumb bevel hip and the level bevel hip set up on my square. And I can actually use this now to start to mark out my square, so on my hip. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to mark the center line. Okay, that is the center, that's going to represent the center of the roof, where the hip would meet the ridge. But obviously it's going to be a little bit shorter than that. So we have to work out what our ridge deduction is. So in this case, our rafter is 35 mil thick. Our crown end rafter is 35 mil thick. So we actually have to take off this amount. So if you do 17.5 squared plus 17.5 squared, we end up with 0.0006125. Square root that, and we end up with 25 mil deduction on the plan view for our deduction at the ridge. So if we go down back to our piece of timber, we can measure square off our bevel, or our plumb bevel, square off 25 mil, and that will give us the actual end point of our ridge, so we know where that is. Okay, so now we can come back to our center line, and we're going to start marking out the length of the hip. So what we need to know, the plan length of our hip if we have a half span of 2.5 meters, and we know that for every meter the hip runs 1.414 meters, so we times 1.414 by 2.5, we end up with 3.535 being the plan length of the hip, which is the length along this side of the side of the square. Okay, so 3.535. So I also know that my square is set up with 471 on here. So if I divide my 3.535 by 0.471, I end up with 7.5 roughly. So it's going to take me 7.5 steps to mark out the length. Now, if I go seven steps of 0.471 will give me a distance of 3.297. And then if I take my original length, 3.535 minus 3.297, it leaves me 238 mil. So what I can do is I can step out 7 steps with the square, and then I have to add on an additional 238 mil to get me to the back of the bird's mouth where I need to be. So with that all worked out, I can start to step it out. So what I'm going to do, now put a little mark where my 471 is, just there, so I can step it out. Then I'm going to move my square down the first step onto that mark, and then mark my next 471, and I'm going to repeat that 7 times. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm getting close. So on my next step, I can now come in here. So I've taken my next step, and this is going to be the short one. So on this step, I only have to go 238 mil. So that's my mark there. Okay, so 238 mil. I haven't made any deduction for the plate yet, so I have to deduct this distance here. Okay, and if my, on a plan view, 90 degree corner, this angle is going to be 45 degrees, so if that's 10 mil, this distance here has to be 10 mil, so I'm going to deduct 10 mil off there. Okay, so this is my original mark, my 238, take 10 mil off. And I can mark out my bird's mouth. So now I have my bird's mouth, remembering to allow for your stand up on your rafter. So then I can come back to my original mark without the deduction, and I've got a mark out for my hip, or sorry, for my overhang. So I've got a 450 overhang on my rafters, so 450 or 0.45 times our 1.414 gives us a length of 0.636. So again, I can just step this out. So the first one I went 400 and put a mark, and now I can go a further 236, which will bring me to around here somewhere, and that is where I'm going to cut my hip off on the 236 mm mark, to the long point of the hip. So there you go, with a little bit of calculation and a steel square, we can work out and mark out and cut the length of our hip. Of course, once we've cut it, we're going to trial fit it, and once we're happy with the trial, we can then use that as a template, and we can go around and cut the rest of our hips in. And that's how we use a steel square to get the length of our hip.